What's the scariest thing that's ever happened to you? When I was 12 or so, my family went camping at a campground in the Shenandoah Valley, not the middle of nowhere but kind of an isolated mountain town. I went to take our dog for a walk out on a trail at the edge of the campground with some pretty dense woods all around. My dog suddenly froze and wouldn't budge, right as I heard some rustling in the woods behind me. I spun around to see some random middle-aged guy emerged from the trees and begin to approach me. I was too surprised to really react, and my dog was super old at that point, so he didn't do much other than freeze. Then the guy goes, "Hey, this is going to seem like a weird question, but could you come back to my cabin and help me cut my hair? I can't see the back of my neck and could really use your help." I quickly said something like, "No, sorry, my parents are waiting on me for dinner, so I should get going." He just shrugged and walked back into the woods. I made it back to our campsite safely and told my parents. I had thought maybe he was a campground employee, but only after my parents' reaction did I realize how weird the interaction was. They immediately went to the campground staff and told them what happened. They searched the campground but never found the guy. I still get goosebumps thinking about it. Was already on the worst date of my life with a barely coherent guy who smelled like he hadn't showered in a week. I was dropping him off at his bike after a glass of wine at a fancy wine bar, where he knew a guy who wasn't working that night, so guess who has two thumbs, and paid for both drinks. This guy. Suddenly dude yells, "Look out," and I slam the brakes. I missed getting demolished by inches by a speeding sub blasting through a stop sign and across an arterial road at 70 km/h. I later found out that it crashed into someone's house shortly thereafter. Anyways, I was shaking like a leaf after that. That guy saved both our lives. Wish I could say it was a meet cute, but I never saw him again. In college one weekend, I crashed at a friend's house and woke up early in the morning, 7 a.m. or so. I decided to walk 5 minutes back to my dorm to get some more sleep in my own bed. As I got close to my dorm, I noticed a man following me. No one else is out walking. He doesn't look college aged either. I start fast walking to the front door. It was after the night security guard, aka paid students, left, so there was no one at the door. I still had to swipe my ID card to get in, and he was very close behind me. I swipe my card, and he sneaks in before the door fully closed and relocked. I bolted up the one flight of stairs to my floor, and down a 80-foot hallway to my room. As I fumbled with my keys, I saw the man enter the walkway, looking left and right to see where I went. I slipped in my room and locked my door. I didn't fall back asleep that morning. And for everyone asking, this happened like 5 months after a guy broke into my dorm room while my roommate and I slept, just watching us. He left eventually. I don't recall how much time passed between waking up and seeing a person walk into our room, thinking it was my roommate, and when they left. Since I dozed off, I called campus security for that, not for the creepy guy who followed me. Not sure why I didn't. Lastly, a few years later, right after I graduated, some man was caught inside my old dorm attempting to break into rooms. He was old and had a white beard. He had a knife on him too. They called him Santa Claus in the school newspaper. I'm a 21-year-old girl and moved to a new city for college and was trying to make friends. There was a comic book store near my apartment and I signed up for a Dungeons & Dragons group. I used my first name, phone number, and a gamer email address, the store employee, and I had some casual conversation on favorite comic book series. We both really liked Batman, so we talked for a good 15 to 20 minutes before I purchased a book with my credit card. Around 9 p.m. the employee texted me like, "Hey, this is store employee. I really enjoyed talking with you today." I was a little unnerved by this, because the only way he has my phone number was because of the D&D sign up sheet. I didn't really want to respond at first, but I didn't want to appear unfriendly and not be invited to the Dungeons & Dragons group, so I responded, "Yeah, I'm glad to have found comic book store. Can't wait to meet the Dungeons & Dragons group. See ya next time." He proceeded to text me a few more times that night, but I didn't respond. He tries to add me on social media. He got my last name from my credit card. The final straw was I was on my college campus after hours studying in the library. I'm packing up my things when he calls me. I look at the phone, hit ignore, and put my phone on the table. He then appears from behind a bookshelf 1 meter away, and has the balls to ask, "Hey, why did you ignore my call?" I literally had this feeling like a wave of cold water from my head to my toes, and I broke out in a cold sweat. I managed to put on my professional retail smile, and was like, "Oh my god, hi, sorry I ignored your call. I was just trying to pack up and head home for the day. How are you?" I was talking very jerky and loudly, because I honestly just hoped I can either make him happy enough not to murder me, or to get someone's attention BC I'm being loud in a library. He was oddly calm, and he was smiling, but not in a warm way. "Why haven't you been returning my texts?" "Without missing a beat, I have to pay for my data. I have a cheapo Walmart plan. Look at this phone. It's ancient. Anyway, I can't wait for D&D on Friday though. I'm so ready to socialize and relax." Then he talked about the campaign and roles that are open, etc. He asked to walk me to my car, and I'll I know thank you. My boyfriend is coming to meet me in a few minutes. His face like turned for a minute, and I was so scared. I remember kicking myself BC it was a straight up lie, but I didn't know what to say to have him not follow me to my car. Then like IDK, if God is real or what, one of my male classmates walked by, and I took my chance. OMG fellow classmate, hey, 1 minute, I turned to store employee, "Hey sorry, I need to catch up with classmate, I'll see you Friday," and I bolted for my classmate. I grabbed his arm like we were best friends and I just started talking about class. I walked us outside, and he got me to my car. It was pitch black outside. I was so scared, but the classmate was so sweet. He got in my car, chilled for a bit, and I drove him to his car. I never went back to the comic book store. I still go to conventions and I saw the store employee a few times, but we never spoke again. I went out for a few drinks with friends one Saturday night, left the bar, and went back to my apartment, where I live alone. I got into bed, and fell asleep. The next morning my friend sent me a message on WhatsApp saying, "Send me the photos from last night." So I flicked through all of the photos from the night before to find at least 20 pictures of me sleeping, and in the background of the photo the shadow of someone on the wall, clearly holding up my phone taking pictures, all dated and timed during the time I would have been asleep. What happened next? I completely had a panic attack, gave my phone to the cops, moved in with my sister and her kids, until I found a new place, told the landlord I had to cut my contract short, and he said he'd move out too. Never to this day did we ever get to the bottom of it. I have a few, but I will share a time I believed my life was in danger. My sister was alive and nanny for a Weatherly couple in an upscale suburb. She got kidney stones, and asked if I could cover for her, because I had experience with babysitting and I could stay with her when she was sick. I went to help. These people were really out there, but it was only for a few days. The mother went to a concert with her girlfriend that night. The father didn't live there, because they were separated. I had literally just met them. There was a 7-year-old boy, and 24-year-olds, a boy and a girl. These poor kids had issues, because a lot was going on. They were in bed and my sister and I were in her room watching TV, when we heard a loud noise coming from downstairs. We go to check things out, and my sister found that a big piece of wood that blocked the basement door had been pushed in. We have the lights on, doors locked, and we call the police. The 7-year-old heard the noise, and he was scared. I told my sister to take him upstairs, and I would wait for the police. I grabbed a knife for the block and I waited downstairs alone for the police to show up. It took about 10 minutes, but it felt like forever. I'm not a violent person, but all I could think was that there were innocent kids upstairs, and if someone attacked I needed to protect them. The police told us they didn't find anything and left. We couldn't get a hold of either parent this whole time. The next day, I was playing with the kids in the yard. I was pushing the twins on the swings, when the 7-year-old said he found something cool and wanted to show me. It was a knife. I asked him if I could please see it. I didn't want to scare him. I take it inside and call the police. Unfortunately, I had to touch it to get it away from the kid. It wasn't a small knife, and it was by the entrance to the basement. They never found the person. Back in university, I went to the restroom. When I came out, there was this guy I'd never seen before waiting in the hall by the women's restroom. He started talking to me as if he knew me and kept asking for help on a specific assignment. I kept telling him that I wasn't in that class while trying to get away. Every time I took a step to the side to walk past him, he would block me and walk towards me, cornering me back into the bathroom with every step. Even though it was broad daylight, I was terrified, and I could tell by his demeanor that something wasn't right. My back was to the bathroom door when he began to pull something out of his backpack. I never saw what it was, because at that very moment another guy walked past and asked if everything was alright, and the first guy left very quickly. I lived about 5 blocks from my job, espresso stand barista, and was walking to work one morning about 8:30 ish along a really busy street. There was a jack-in-the-box kitty corner from the espresso stand, and as I was walking past the parking lot, a guy in a 70s muscle car stopped me to ask if I knew where thus and such high school was. I told him it was on the other side of town, but he insisted there was one right in the neighborhood where we were. There was a private school a few blocks away, but it wasn't a high school. As I was talking to him, his passenger had gotten out and walked around on the sidewalk, so he was behind me. I gave them directions to the private school: literally go down this road 3 blocks, turn left at the brown duplex with the pine trees in the front yard, drive 2 more blocks and you're in the parking lot. But they were just certain they'd get lost. They really wanted me to get in the car and go with them. Every hair on the back of my neck was at attention. I told them my boss was waiting for me and pointed to where not just my boss stood, but a bunch of the larger guys from the car detailing slash windshield installation strip mall were keeping an eye on the situation. I shook as I crossed that street. A couple of the big windshield dudes crossed to meet me, and the guys in the car took off. My grandma has a summer beach house and you can only get there by boat. One time, we took the boat to go to the house, but the boat straight up stopped working right next to some very sharp looking rocks, and after it, a small but pretty scary waterfall. So, the boat is freaking dead. It won't do crap, and the boat starts moving toward the super sharp rocks followed by the waterfall. So we are all very scared at this point, and my dad is desperately trying to get this thing to work, and then the boat engine starts working again, and we finally get the hell out of there. I actually thought we were going to die. When I was 13, I was walking home from a friend's house at 10 o'clock at night, and my house was only a few miles away, and I had about a mile left to go till I got back till my house, when a man about 5 feet 10 who had seemingly dark hair and seemingly dark eyes turned the same corner that I had turned to cross over to my neighborhood. So I thought that he was one of the neighbors and continued down back towards my house. Well, I decided to stop and see if he stopped, just to mess with him a little, and he stopped as well. So I started walking again, and he started walking again, so I speed, and he speed up. Well, I had about a half mile till I got back to my house, and decided to pull out my phone and turn on the flashlight and point it at his face to see his reaction, and he just smiles at me with his nasty teeth, and I just book it the half mile home, and never saw him again. It was 1992, I'm 12 years old, my brother, 9 years old, decides to call his friend on an old style rotary phone. Yes, we had one. When he picks up the receive, there is no dial tone, but a bubbling sound. He calls me over to listen, and it sounds just like what I would imagine a witch's cauldron to sound like. Then a female voice, sounds just like the Wicked Witch of the West plus 30 years of heavy smoking, comes on and says, "The next time you go walking, I'm going to kill you." And then it repeats that over and over. I expected it was my mom playing a joke on the other phone, so I holler at her and say, "Haha, very funny, mom." She comes out of her room from putting makeup on, getting ready to go out, when I see her standing in the doorway with my ear still to the receiver and that voice and bubbling. I do one of those Hollywood slow takes and look at the phone, back at her, and throw the receive to the floor and start crying my eyes out. Of course, this freaks her out too. This went on for a week. The police couldn't figure out what was happening, and the phone company couldn't explain it either. Best guess was someone was phone freaking us, but we never confirmed it. I never did die, but I stopped walking by myself after that. Still gives me goosebumps. I was snorkeling on the outside of an intercoastal in South Florida. I had no real experience doing it before. There's a big wall of rocks separating the area we were snorkeling and jet skiing in from ships and boats entering and exiting the intercoastal. We climbed up on the rocks for fun, and I had to take off my flippers to do so. I jumped into the intercoastal area, and without my flippers on, I was instantly sucked out into the middle of the intercoastal as a cruise ship was coming through. The details about how close I was to getting hit and exactly how much danger I was in are a bit blurry, but I absolutely thought to myself I could die right now. My friend's dad swooped in on his jet ski and saved me. One night I was walking home from the bus stop, only a straight 3-block walk, and a car that was driving in the opposite direction that I was walking slowed down as it neared me. It was a man who rolled down his window, and he was trying to talk to me, trying to get me to come into the car, but I always used to put headphones in my ear and pretend like I'm listening to music to ward off random men. Anywho, I'm on the 2nd block near my house and I peek behind my shoulder to see the same car making a U-turn. I didn't want him to know where I lived, and I was nearing the last block to my house, which had a secret driveway. If I just turned the corner before my block point, I started running, and I turned the corner, but he sped up turned with me. All of a sudden someone shouted my name across the street, and it was my mom. 0.0. When I tell you, that man sped away so fast. At a few I was so scared, and she was asking me why would I turn the corner, and I was asking her why are you randomly outside in the middle of the night. She said something told her to go outside and meet me as I was walking home. I'm a 19-year-old college girl at South Plains College in Livelland, Texas, 1973. It was a cowboy college, and I had my horse there with me, barn on campus. Though I rode an English saddle, I was training for an endurance ride, had ridden Julia hard, and was walking back to the bar to cool her off. I was in the middle of a cotton field on the turn row, kicked my feet out of the stirrups, reins on her neck, arms folded across my chest. She was walking along very relaxed, head down and bobbing, when she lifted her head and looked behind us. I picked up my reins and stirrups and turned around in the saddle, and right behind me was powder blue Rambler car with two men in it. Looked like drunk scruffy painters, if you can visualize. I leaned forward in my saddle and we took off like a shot. Ran all the way back to the barn with them chasing me. When I got to the barn, some other male students were there, and I told them what happened, and could they stay until I had walked my horse cool. For those that don't know, you do not water a hot sweaty horse. It will founder them and cripple their feet. They stayed while I cooled Julia, and we watched as they drove around campus looking. When Julia was put up, we all waited until the car was hidden by buildings, and then we all jumped in our cars and scattered. I went straight to my dorm and hid. Never saw them again. Years later, two mass murderers were arrested, Henry Lee Lucas and Otis Toll. It was them, and my blood ran cold. At this time they were in Ringgold, Texas, and murdered a woman there. Also drove a powder blue Rambler. Henry was an excellent mechanic and could make an engine purr. The reason he go so close to us, had he known much about horses, he would have honked the horn before Julia saw him. She would have jumped, and I would have rolled right off of her. He was close enough I would almost hit the hood of the car. My beloved Julia saved my life that day. My mother developed cancer the next year and died, and I have thought often of how it would have destroyed my father to lose his wife and oldest daughter. From that day forth I want to know where my enemy is and what he is doing, wherever and whoever I perceive him to be. Stay safe out there.